iOS 18.4 Beta 2 came out, and we have new shortcuts actions. Several of Apple's first-party apps have now added actions allowing you to change the settings for those apps using shortcuts actions. So now you can automate changing map settings through focus modes, how new reminders are set based on time of day, change your search engine in Safari on the fly, plus actions for calendars, notes, news, and more. I'm going to show you all the new actions available in 18.4 and some new shortcuts to take advantage of them. Keep in mind, this is the 18.4 developer beta, so you're not going to see this in the public release. We also have things like the new Apple Vision Pro app now on the second beta for the first time. But let's get into all the new actions in shortcuts. I've created a shortcut here with every new action based on Apple's first-party apps. Doesn't have all the apps, but some of the big ones. First off, starting with Calendar, you can change all these settings now based on an action, from things like adding a time to leave alert, changing what day your week starts on, default duration for new events, and more. Freeform, you have a couple new actions here like guides and select and scroll. Apple Books gets a couple actions, even changing the reading menu position on the fly. Apple Maps has a bunch of actions here like toggling avoiding highways, avoiding tolls, and one that I'm gonna work into a shortcut in a moment, which is changing the volume level for turn-by-turn directions. Apple News gets a number of them like automatically downloading recipes, puzzles, and again, this is controlling the settings for these apps. Apple Notes gets a number of actions like resume last quick note, turning on or off the local notes account. Reminders get some new actions like including the due today reminder, which maybe you want to toggle that off during certain focus modes. I'll show you how to do that in a second. Safari gets a bunch of actions, including how tabs are displayed, whether or not you want to toggle autofill on or off, blocking pop-ups, and even changing your search engine. Apple TV gets a bunch of actions. This is the TV app, not controlling your Apple TV. But you can change your download settings, quality settings, default languages and subtitles. That's pretty cool. And Weather gets two whole actions for toggling the home and work locations and changing the temperature unit, which might be nice if you want to toggle that from Fahrenheit to Celsius, mirror the system, or even ask each time. So I've built a couple shortcuts taking advantage of these new actions. Now I'm running this on an iPhone 14, so I'm going to do some back taps, but you could map these to the action button on newer iPhones as well. We'll start with the start week on. So right here I have a start week on, and you can choose a specific day, but I'm actually going to do the ask each time. This way I can change the start day of my week to whatever I want. Right now you see Sunday is the start of the week. Well, if I double tap on the back, it actually pulls up all the days of the week. And if I want to go crazy and start my week on Wednesday, I can change my whole calendar with a single tap. Run the shortcut again, and if I want it to start on Monday, like it's supposed to be, I can just tap Monday, and it changes the whole calendar there. We can even change the duration for new events. You can set a hard time, like 30 minutes, 60 minutes, or we can choose Ask Each Time again. So if we go back to the calendar, I'll run the shortcut. So now I can change the default event time to 1 hour. Now if I create a new event here in the calendar, you'll see the duration is automatically 1 hour. Run the shortcut by back tapping, and maybe I want to change it to 30 minutes. Well, I can do that, tap plus, and now you'll see the event default is 30 minutes. And remember, you can customize this for when your focus mode changes or even on days of the week. Another great one of these control actions is toggling the volume level for turn-by-turn directions. You have the option for a softer, normal, or louder volume, or again, we can choose ask each time. I'm gonna set this as my back tap, which if you weren't sure, you go to the settings, go to accessibility, scroll down, and then you'll see back tap at the bottom. Enable that, and then you can choose double or triple tap. You can program two different shortcuts. If you scroll all the way down, then you'll see all the shortcuts you have here. I'll choose the Maps Volume shortcut. Let's go over to Maps. Now if I double tap, that shortcut runs, and I can change the volume right here. Maybe go to normal volume. And if I open the menu here, you'll see right now it's reflected as normal. But I'll tap again. Now that I chose louder volume, I can go to the voice volume here, and now you'll see it's louder. Now obviously the best way to utilize that would be something like an automation. So for instance, let's create an automation. I'll press the plus button here, and we could base this on focus modes, like for the evening focus mode, use the softer volume, but we can also do this for time of day. So we'll choose time of day at sunset. We want this to be daily. We'll have it run immediately. Hit next, new blank automation, and now let's search for the change map settings. Now I'll choose change maps, and we can select which action we want. We'll go down to the volume level, and we can now set the volume level to softer. So after sunset, that turn by turn is going to be softer, and we can create another automation for the morning if we want to set it for normal or louder. Again, here for Apple Books, you can change something like the reading menu position. I'll set this for my double tap back tap. Now I'll see the menu icon is in the bottom right. If I double tap to run the shortcut, I can choose put that in the left, and now you'll see that moved over to the left. Now, some of the most exciting settings that you can change are now in Safari. Things like changing your search engine, whether or not you want to block pop-ups. That might be helpful if you need to open some work websites that have pop-ups. You can even change the look of the tab bar, enable or disable autofill. But let's try the search engine. We're going to use the ask each time. And now if we go over to Safari, if I triple tap to run that shortcut, it'll actually give me the choice of what search engine I want to use. Let's say DuckDuckGo. And ideally, when you now search in the address bar, it's going to use that other search engine. It seems like in this very first beta, it is not working properly. It just keeps defaulting to Google. I could try another search engine like Ecosia, and it still just defaults to Google. Again, I imagine that's a bug. This is the first time these actions have been in iOS, so hopefully that'll be fixed soon. But you can also do things like toggle Safari suggestions. I'll actually set this to toggle. So if we go to Safari and we begin typing, so right now you see Safari suggestions are off. I'm starting to type 9 to 5 and nothing's showing up. But if I run that shortcut with a triple tap, it should toggle those Safari suggestions on. And now as I type 9 to 5, you'll see that Safari suggestion now shows up at the top. And some other ideas for things like news. If you want to automatically download puzzles and stories, you can have that toggle when you go into travel focus mode. And this way, if you're going on a plane, those things will be waiting for you. Whether or not to enable that local note account, which I'll put that as a shortcut real quick. And let's go to the notes app. Well, apparently you can't toggle it off if there's notes there. Probably a good measure so you don't delete a bunch of stuff by accident. And let's do one more in reminders. Maybe we want to toggle that today notification. Typically you'd have to go to settings, reminders, and there's that today notification. It's toggled on right now. But if I run a shortcut that toggles it, you'll see it automatically toggles off. I'm immediately going to put that setting into one of my focus modes. So for instance, I'll go back to shortcuts, automations, tap plus, and then we can do something like weekend. When weekend is turned on, we want this to run immediately. New blank automation. We'll look for the change reminder settings, and we want that today notification to turn off when my weekend focus mode is on. Then we can do a second notification for when my weekend focus mode turns off, so during the week, I can then turn that reminder setting back on. So turn today notification back on, and we'll hit done. So there's a lot of things you can do with these new shortcuts actions, but I think it's telling for the app intents and the more powerful voice assistant on the iPhone that should be coming sometime this year. So get subscribed and hit that like button. I'll cover any new shortcuts actions and hopefully new automations triggers as they come out. If you have any questions, leave comments below this video. And if you want to see my top 5 changes coming to iOS 18.4, likely releasing to the public next month, check out this video right up here. And if you want to learn more about shortcuts, my latest shortcuts video includes automatically tracking your mileage, summarizing and transcribing podcasts, and more. You can check out that video right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.